And now, keep on singing with the Heritage Singers.
Well, I keep on singing till he gets here. I keep talking about my Lord. I get down on my knees each day, take time to read his word. I'll share the good news of salvation with people every day. And nothing's gonna keep me from going home when he calls me on that day. Everyone seems anxious over what the future holds. Men's hearts failing them for fear, and love is growing cold. Heartaches and broken homes are reasons folks are insecure.
And if this old world should end tonight, I know salvation would be sure.
And I'll keep on singing till he gets here. All I keep is talking about my Lord. I get down on my knees each day, take time to read his word.
Hello, everyone. My name is Max Mace, along with the Heritage Singers. And here we are in beautiful Sacramento, California, in Old Town, the first town right here in this beautiful city. We're here praising the Lord in the beautiful sunshine, and it's a beautiful day here in Sacramento. This first song that we'd like to start our show out with is a song that says there's too many people that believe in fairy tales. I want you to listen to the words.
Start to tell you all the places I've seen, from LA lights to New York nights and everything in between. And everywhere I go, I see people who need to know of the love that Jesus gives, of a better way to live. There's just too many people who still believe in fairy tales. Too many people who don't believe in heaven above. Not enough people who still believe that Jesus never fails. And too many people who don't believe in his love. Ask me, how can I travel another mile? They say relax, face the facts, settle down a while. But there's just too little time. We're living on the line. So I'll keep on singing his songs. I'll sing them just as long as there's too many people who still believe in fairy tales. Too many people who don't believe in heaven above. Not enough people who still believe that Jesus never fails. And too many people who don't believe in his love.
I'd like to share with you. It's found in Isaiah 1:18, and it says, "Come, let's talk this over," says the Lord. "No matter how deep the stain of your sins, I can take it out and make you as clean as freshly fallen snow. Even if you are stained as red as crimson, I can make you white as wool." The secret is to ask for forgiveness. Christ has already paid the price for you and me at Calvary.
And in me, not one blemish does he see. When I place all my burdens on him, he washed them all from me. Oh, why did I wait so long?
Time when no one gave me time of day. You looked deep inside while the rest of the world looked away. You smiled at me when there were just frowns everywhere. You gave me love when nobody gave me. Why I call you friend. You touch my heart, you touch my soul, and help me start all over again. That's why I love you, Jesus. That's why I'll always care.
You give me love when nobody gave me a prayer. Me love. laughter after I cried all my tears. You heard my dreams while the rest of the world closed its ears. I looked in your eyes and I found the tenderness there. You gave me love when nobody gave me a prayer.
That's why I call you Savior. That's why I call you friend. You touch my heart, you touch my soul, and help me start all over again. That's why I love you, Jesus. That's why
have you ever tried to describe to someone what a special friend means to you? You might say that you love them or you trust them or a number of other things, but they really don't cover the subject. Sometimes it's hard to tell someone what another person really means to you. That's kind of the way it is with Jesus. Until you really experience that relationship with him, there's no way that you can feel it. Christ means more to me than you could ever know unless you experience yourself.
If I could find the right words to say, to tell you just what Christ means to me, I'd say he's more than I could show. Just yesterday, you'd know why he's life and breath to me. You'd know why he's more.
Oh.
The reason that he suffered and died. recorded words spoken to his disciples, but yet they've been the source of inspiration for Christians in ages past and for Christians today, and will continue to be the Great Commission for Christians of tomorrow.
Go ye therefore and teach all nations. Go, go, go. Go ye therefore and teach all nations. Go, go, go. Baptizing them in the name of the Father and Son and Holy Ghost. Go, go, go.
Go. That's the commission that Jesus Christ gave his disciple just before he sent it into heaven. He told them to go and to preach the gospel into every kindred, tongue, and people. And then soon he would come back and take us all home. Folks, we're holding on to that promise. You know, my God has never broken a promise. And I'm holding on to it, and I believe that what he says is true, that he's coming back to take me home. Going to take you home too. So keep holding on. Keep sharing the good news of the gospel. Let's share it. Let's love people more. Let's get out there and get the work done, folks, so we can go home. I'm homesick for heaven, aren't you? I want to go home. Well, we'll be coming into your town soon. Watch your newspapers, television. We'll be into your area soon, and we want you to come and meet us in person. Every week we come into your home with a live television program, but we want to come and see you personally. So thank you for supporting us, thank you for believing us, and thank you for praying for us. We'd just like to say that we're looking forward to coming to your home next week, where you can bring the whole family together, and we can just share the Lord together. We'd just like to say, may God be with you until we meet again.
Special thanks to Hyatt Regency Hotels for providing accommodations and great service nationwide and across the world.
May God